just get out of here. Can I pick up any of these? I can pick up that one. But again, what I really need is Brock Flower. Not Xander Root. Okay, well that just about does it for here. Oh, you know what I didn't pick up while I was there? Didn't pick up the medical kit. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout New Vegas, where the sky is beginning to take on a pinkish hue because the day is coming to an end. It is 6:32 p.m. We have returned to the Lone Wolf radio station, and I've picked up the medical kit that was on that shelf there. So, now we actually have what we need this time. It's probably time we got going. What do you... Are you scouting now, is it? Are you... Bert the Scout? Ugh.
Motherfuck.
Sledgehammer. It's really not that difficult a concept to get your head around. Don't know why he does that, to be honest. It is irritating, though. Okay, those are those dead geckos. That over there. Oh, it's road signs. Just saw a dark blocky object over there, and I was just sort of curious. So, anyway. Moving on. Oh, hello, look at that. Radio towers of some description. So yeah, now all we need to do is get back to Good Springs and find ourselves one more locker in an abandoned house or something, and hope it wasn't in the coyote cave. Probably was, wasn't it? But yeah, find one more locker and then we can get Paul and Dean to set us up with some proper storage and things. Don't know what we'll do about the electricity, but you know, one thing at a time. Boxes. Be thirsty. A little bit. Shall we bottle our water? Yes. We're probably a little hungry as well. Not too bad, actually. Mainly just tired. More than anything else, I believe, as well, actually. And I think I'm going to do this. On configuration. Extra HUD. General. Show primary needs as meters/bars. Ah, there you go, look at that. That's actually a bit more useful, to be honest with you. It gives you a better frame of reference, because I don't really know what 40 hunger really means in real terms, you know? Whereas a bar's much better, and also it tells me that I'm ridiculously close to my carrying capacity, but that's fine. I've got this guy for that little problem. And soon we'll have lots of lockers and things to dump stuff into, so. Sadly, we probably won't have, No, I don't have any other grenades, just these sticks of dynamite, which I need to remember that I've got, to be honest with you, because I can use them to break things open. I probably could have used them to break open that chest. I mean, chest. Safe. Back in the cigarettes bit. But I can't be bothered, so screw it. Screw it, screw it, screw it. That's just right, okay. So let's have a hunt around before it gets too dark. We search this bit. We search pretty much all of it. Everyone's around here, so. Check. I think there's a few ruined buildings up this way as well, so. the neglected half of Good Springs. It has to be said, because there's pretty much nothing here. Nothing useful anyway. The hell? Hello. Random person staring at me from out of their camper van. Ooh. Locked very easy, eh? Don't mind if I... Ugh, God. Do. Four 9mm rounds. Very good. Pinion nuts. Whatever. Long fuse dynamite. Damn. I probably could break that open with dynamite, but, I don't know. I think the citizens of Good Springs might have something to say about that. I could have sworn... Ah, there it is. I knew it. Empty. Shame. Right, then let's see. Scrap metal and a locker! Hooray! We've located 6 lockers. All the containers for the Sims system. Right, awesome. Okay, the other thing I need to do is pop over to the workbench and make myself a flashlight belt. Hopefully it'll work with this armor. Come to think of it, it might not. I might need to get a harness or something, which will just be very, very irritating. But... No, it does work with the leather armor. Okay, awesome. So now... I've got a flashlight strapped to a belt, which I can then shine at people. Like this. Is that annoying? Oh yeah, I can switch it back to the normal. Non-wide beam version. There we go. Awesome.
Evening.
Is it just me? Or, yeah, it does really mess with the frame rate having this on outdoors. Big time. Not noticeable for you lot, because it's above 30fps, and I don't upload in 60fps. At least not for now, anyway. It's a topic I've discussed many times. But who knows... There's the good old homestead. And over here is... Ah, right.
Hello. What did you need?
Never mind. I'll go find Paul instead.
We were all amazed to hear the doc pulled you through. Good to see you among the living. Was there something I can help you with?
It looks like I found all the containers you said we need.
You got everything already? Wow, that's impressive. But there's one thing we need to talk about before we proceed. If you stored anything of value in any of those old lockers in the school, you need to head out and grab your gear before we move forward. Dean's going to haul those old lockers off for scrap metal and set the new ones up for you. He'll most likely do it tomorrow, so you can't forget to remove anything you want to keep. Otherwise, it's getting hauled off.
Right, okay. That's obviously just telling us in case we did, like he says, store anything in there. The mod is going to delete it all, so... No, I don't have anything stored in the school. Let's proceed.
Very well, then. Listen, there's something that's been on my mind. It just ain't right having you sleep on that filthy old mattress in there. I was going to save this for later. But when Dean sets up the lockers, I'm going to get him to take a nicer bed over for you so you can be well rested.
Oh, thank God. Least I can. Finally.
So you'll have a much better bed and plenty of containers. Put anything in them you want and your gear will be perfectly safe. I know it's not quite a home yet, but we're getting there bit by bit. Go get some rest, and when you're ready, we'll go over what we have left to do.
Fantastic. Quest added. Homeroom. Go back and talk to Paul when you're ready to proceed. Well, that'll be tomorrow then. Quite definitely. Well, nothing's changed yet, but that's fair enough, really. Okay, well, time to get another night's sleep. Let's go 9 hours-ish. I'm not, yeah, that'll do. No, it won't. Probably won't. Miscalculated again. Yeah. Alright. Dean has installed the sim storage system. You just need to get the power back on and the system will be fully functional. Dear God, he did all that while I was asleep? And that was, that was sneaky. Oh, in God's name, did he manage that? You had a hand in this, didn't you? Awesome. So, we've got a first aid box. We've got a safe. We've got categorized lockers. My goodness. Another little safe. A desk with pre-war money in it. A fridge. A bunch of temporary lighting. That'll work. Clutter. My good old flashlight. I can just switch on the touch of a button now. I do love that. I really do. I think it's fantastic. So much more practical. Garbage. Which actually, like, has an animation on it. That's kind of cool. Thank you for the 20 bottle caps in the garbage. Workbench parts. Reloading parts. Metal box. Sorted ammo. Oh, this will all be for the Sims thing once it's up and running. How exactly are we going to get any electricity going, though? I'm not really sure, to be honest. Anyway, come over here, you. Come here. Give me all your things.
Motherfucker.
Let's see. Right, I think I'm going to pause the recording here while I do all this boring inventory sorting stuff, so I'll be back in a bit. Okay, we are all sorted. Everything has been sorted. Everything I want to sort, anyway. Mostly workbench parts and guns and ammo and that kind of thing. This armor's starting to grow on me, by the way. It's very classic Fallout. Really. Sort of feels fitting. The first armor you really got in Fallout 1 was leather armor like this, so. In fact, it looked very, very similar to this. In fact, indeed it did, actually. Come to think of it, so. Yeah. Or was that... No, I think reinforced leather armor like this was a separate thing altogether as well. That you got later. Well, anyway. Let's go talk to Paul. Wherever he is, he's probably inside somewhere. You can just... Hello? Ah, there you are.
Yes, sir. Another scorcher here in the Mojave. How you doing, neighbor?
You were going to fill me in on the wiring for the school.
Yes. Luckily, the wiring in the walls is intact and ready to be tied into the new solar power system. It's pretty genius, actually, but it's still very simple. The sun charges the batteries, and the batteries power the school. The batteries are inside of a UPS, or uninterrupted power supply, that Dean's been fixing up. He tells me that everything checks out so far except for the inversion coil in the thing. It's completely burned out and needs to be replaced. Also, in addition to the coil, we need a small solar panel to use to charge the whole thing up.
You said inversion coil? What's that?
Well, it's a nifty piece of tech. The simple explanation is the solar panel collects energy from the sun and sends it to the UPS system. The UPS system uses that energy to keep its batteries charged, but the power from the batteries is DC voltage. And unfortunately, everything in the school runs off of AC voltage. That's why the UPS has the inversion coil, or inverter, to convert the DC to AC so it can power up the school. It converts the power, feeds it to the transfer switch, which sends the power to the main panel and on into the school.
What about if there's no sun for a while?
Yes, excellent question. That could be a problem, could it not? Well, this system also has a backup generator that kicks in if the batteries get too drained. The generator also recharges the batteries when the UPS is offline. Everything ties into the transfer switch, which controls which power source is being used. It transfers or switches back and forth between the solar and generator power, depending on which one is online.
Kind of switched off there a bit. You see what it did there? Never mind. Any idea where I can find a coil in a solar panel?
Not sure, but the only place we might have a chance finding them would be that old solar energy facility called Helios 1. Hell, I'm not even sure you can get into that place anymore. NCR's got it on lockdown these days. Are you up for giving it a shot?
I'll see what I can find.
Now, I didn't mean literally give it a shot, so don't go getting yourself killed over this. I'll let Dean know to go ahead and get everything installed. If you can find that coil and solar panel, just give them to Dean when you come back. That way you two can work together on the installation. Good luck.
Right, we're going to go to Helios 1. That's forever away, that is. It's like halfway across the world, yeah, oh god, well that'll have to happen, that'll have to occur at a much later date. I think we have other things to do in the meantime, I suppose. Well, we put that on hold for now, Ghost Town Gunfight. Oh yeah, we're supposed to talk to Sunny Smiles about fighting the Powder Gangers, right, yeah, you know, actual important stuff.
Motherfucker.
Dehydration levels. Oh, yeah. I'm probably really bloody thirsty. Purified water. That's better. I guess we could have... We could get our food out of the fridge and have something to eat. That's the problem with us having sorted everything now. It's... I don't actually have any of the food on me I actually need. Let's take, like... That should do us for now. Gecko steak. Yum, yum, yum. There we go. Okay, we're good. Yes. I think while we're up in that end of town anyway, I'll go to the... Well, I want to go to the workbench first, because I've got a bunch of gecko hides I want to see if I can turn into belts. And just because they sell for more. And then also I want to sell a bunch of other stuff to Chet. And then we'll go talk to Sunny Smiles about this whole Powder Gangers thing. So. Hello, by the way. Who the bloody hell are you? Sergeant Arcus. Greetings, citizen. What's your story? I'm a sergeant with the NCR. Many of us have been reassigned to maintain our hold over friendly settlements. Mostly to keep the trade routes open, but to be honest, I think it's a PR exercise too. Despite our greatest efforts, we still don't have the best reputation around these parts. I had friends here once upon a time, used to be a good town. Well, still is, but after Prim fell, many settlers moved north. People just want to escape the Powder Gangers. Can't say that I blame them, this place is wide open for attack. Any info you can share with me? Yeah, a guy turned up in town 2 weeks back. He tunneled to safety from a local vault. God knows how. He was in a state of... I got a few details out of him. There was something about another vault launching an attack. That's something about giant monsters and squirrels. He was staying with me until a few days ago, and he just left silently in the middle of the night. I have no idea where he went. Any place I can think of is back to his vault. NCR have classified the area as off-limits until they have sufficient troops to check the vault for supplies. My guess is that'll never happen, but I could get arrested if I'm seeing the area in the meantime. I know where his cave entrance is if you want to check the place out, but it sounds like a death trap to me. Oh, okay. A vault. Where would that be then? Good Spring Cemetery, Good Spring School, Good Spring... Vault 40! It's there. Huh. Might be worth checking out. Oh, you have to, that's such a nice touch. This immersive first person thing. Not as much as this. I mean, this is cool, but just the fact that I have a shadow now in first person. I love that. Anyway. Yeah, let's make some belts. Why not? And... okay, break down the 5mm. And turn it into 5.56! Excellent! And... I guess that's fine. I'd like to make 308s, really, but I don't know what... case of lead, primer, large rifle. I wonder if we could get some of that at the ammo shop down the road. We've got 252 caps. I don't know how that far that'll get us, really, but we'll see if we can get a few more here.
You looking to buy some supplies?
Yes. Well, sell them, mostly. 357 Magnum Revolver. I meant to shove that in a locker somewhere. I didn't mean to bring that with me. Never mind. Okay. Oh, Wasteland Survival Guide. I need to read that. You can have this whiskey. I'm probably not going to end up drinking it, so... Stealth Boys I'll keep. What else? Buff out. Jet. Psycho. Steady. Pre-war money. Gecko eggs. I could make a pretty penny just selling bottles of purified water, couldn't I, really? As long as I keep finding enough empty bottles. Microfusion breeder. That's not worth anything, apparently. Leather belts. Ah, yeah, all of those. I kind of feel like I want to keep the Vault 21 jumpsuit just for old time's sake, really. Charger rifle I could sell. It's not brilliant, is it, really? I mean... but it just has unlimited ammo. You can't... you almost can't put a price on that, you know? 186 will do for now, yeah.
Thanks. Take it easy now.
Okay. Okay, yeah, we will talk to Sunny Smiles. We will, honest. Her dog's out here for some reason. But we will. I just want to go to the ammo shop first. I really need more action points, because I can't run very far at all, can I? I like being able to sprint. Oh, hello, Joe Cobb. How you doing? How's things? This armor of yours worth anything? My god, it is! Thank you very much. Hey, you wait out here with the robot. I don't want to give him the wrong idea or anything, you know? It's nothing personal. Motherfucker. You watch your language. Right. Oh. Christ, okay. I take things pretty seriously around here, it seems. Hello and welcome to Frankie's Guns and Ammo. Who are you? Frankie, obviously. Name's Frankie and I run this here gun shop now. What can I do for you? Let's see what you have in stock. Sure, here you go. Okay. Oof. He's got like every ammo under the sun, including 50 caliber. Jesus. Though it's kind of funny how 12.7mm and 50 caliber are separate things in this game. I'm reasonably sure they're the same goddamn thing in real life, aren't they? It's the exact same bullet, just with a different name. Whatever. I'll just ignore it. I could be wrong. I have been plenty of times before when it comes to gun stuff. So, wow, you've got everything here, haven't you? Bloody hell. Boxing tape. It's almost worth getting, really. I'd rather get something like brass knuckles or something, really. I mean, has he got brass knuckles? No. A power fist would be the best, oh yeah. That'd make punching things worth it. Problem is, like, people have... I believe I may have mentioned this earlier, but then got stuck on a tangent, but... people say that unarmed is pretty good, but with the realistic weapons damage mods, it makes it difficult, because... I tend to get shot dead before I can actually reach the target in order to punch them in the face. So, you know, that limits the usefulness of an armed combat significantly in this game, I feel. Which is why I made those comments about it being a bit sort of pointless to take it, but I don't know. If we get a power fist. Hell, some power fist and some power armor, then we'll be in business. God damn, look at all this stuff. I wonder if he's got any mods for stuff that I've already got. Laser recycler. I can put that on a... No, that's for a laser RCW, isn't it? Rebar club, reinforcing rods, wow. Recharger, supercharger coil. That's crazy expensive, never mind. Pre-war books, nails, rockets, high explosive rockets, incendiary rockets. Oh my goodness. Well, powder, that's what I want. Powder. Case. Right. Okay, we've got cases of stuff now. Primer and powder we want. What do I want? I suppose I want a bit of all of them, really. Yeah, that'll probably do it. Accept 58 caps. Yeah, fine. Gotta go. Alright then. Oh my god. If we could rob this place. Anyway. Put the thought out of your mind, you'd never get away with it in one piece.
Motherfucker.
Come on.
Motherfucker.
You'll learn one day, I'm sure. Oh! I always forgot. Cobb's armor. Hello, welcome, blah, blah, blah. Yep. There it is. And powder ganger guard armor. There we go. That's more like it. Excellent. I no doubt got loads of comments bitching at me for not picking up his armor a couple of episodes ago, but never mind. Never mind. So now we're in the money. I guess we can... Then now we can afford to be altruistic. Let's go say hello to the good folks over at the saloon. Sonny, there you are. What are you doing, man?
I don't think Joe Cobb knew what hit him. I'm hoping you took him down for a good reason and not for fun.
Would it be so terrible if it was both? Well, I'm going to help Ringo take on the powder gang, as I might need your help.
Say no more. I'm in.
Well, that was easy.
Even though Joe Cobb's dead, his friends will come after the town eventually. However, between you, me, and Ringo, we aren't exactly a force to be reckoned with. A lot of people around here look up to Trudy. If you could convince Trudy to join us, some of the folks in town might decide to help out as well. I know Easy Pete's got a stock of dynamite somewhere. And Chet just got a shipment of leather armor we could borrow. Talk to them as well. Finally, there's a good chance we'll all end up with extra holes in us. So if Doc Mitchell could cough up some extra stim packs, that'd be great.
Okay, any ideas on how to convince Trudy to join us?
A silver tongue would help.
Well.
Convincing Trudy that we had a good plan to win the fight would also help.
What about Chet?
I don't think give is in Chet's vocabulary. Even with the town at stake, he'd still make you barter with him.
What about Easy Pete's dynamite?
Easy Pete's pretty protective of his dynamite. You'd have to convince him you know a thing or two about explosives before you handed it over.
Mm-hmm. Alright then.
I'll be waiting.
Okie doke. Well, Trudy, hello, my dear. How are you doing?
So you're planning on taking on Joe Cobb's gang. It's a big risk, but I suppose you have to do what you think is right.
You should help me take down the powder gang. Bullets, explosions, lots of fun.
I was planning on sitting this one out, but for some reason, I can't help but like you. I'm with you. Let me have a word with a few other folks, and I'll see if I can't round up some more members for this militia you're creating. While everyone does own a gun, we could stand to be a little better equipped. The general store probably has what we need in stock.
Okie dokie.
Be careful out there.
Will do. That's the general plan, and when I can't be careful, I just use this guy.
Hello.
I'll, like, hide behind him, really. I'm not ashamed to admit it. I've got him for a reason. Okay, chat. This is going to be interesting.
You looking to buy some supplies?
I need supplies to fight the powder gangers.
Now just hold on. I never voted to take on the powder gangers. That's a 1,000 cap investment you're talking about.
How about 5.56 millimeter investment in your face if you don't help us? 24 of 25. Oh, I can sort this. I can do this. Salesman Weekly. There we go.
You looking to buy some supplies? This again? Like I said, I'm against taking on the powder gangers. My supplies aren't cheap, you know.
Well, find them. Let them take over the town, then. I'm sure your business will be much better off.
You made your point. I can provide people with some leather armor and extra ammo. Sure hope it's worth it. And I'll be guarding the store while all this is going on. I have to put my business first. You understand.
Yes, you slimy Dave little man. You're lucky I need you to buy my things. Anyway, well, with that out of the way, I guess. Repair my leather armor, which is not a bad idea. And now, I suppose we better go see Doc Mitchell. Oh, no, let's go see Easy Pete first. We've not spoken to Easy Pete yet, I don't think. Oh, we've got badass NCR Ranger lady here. I think we'll be fine, really, but...
Howdy. What can Easy Pete do for you?
Hey, you've got dynamite. It would help us beat the powder gangers.
Too dangerous. Gonna kill all yourselves if I let you touch it. Better to leave it buried. Safer that way.
How hard can it be? Just light them and throw.
Too dangerous. Sorry. Blow yourself up. Blow your neighbor up. Blow the whole town up.
Fine. Do you know anything about the people who attacked me?
The one in the fancy suit seemed to be calling the shots. That's as much as I know. Other folks in town might know more. Word of advice, though. If you ever catch up with him, watch out. The man's got cold eyes like a snake. Can't be trusted, I'd say.
Yes, the man who shot me in the head. You don't say he can't be trusted. Why are you called Easy Pete?
Was a prospector until I decided to settle here to get away from the NCR. Now, we'll just take it easy and help out with the Brahmin and Bighorners.
You're a prospector? Like, digging for gold and silver?
Nah. Means I poke through old buildings looking for working tech and such. Some folks just call it salvaging, but never liked the term. Way I see it, salvage means it's broken, near worthless. Me, I look for the good stuff. Guns, chems, spare parts. Good money in it.
What's wrong with the NCR?
Don't get me wrong. The NCR's got a lot of decent folk in it. It's just that they make you part of them whether you like it or not. Towns like Good Springs and Prim don't stay independent for long. Not if you've got something the NCR wants. Still, the NCR keeps the Legion away.
Tell me about the Legion.
They're slavers, led by a guy named Caesar, or Kaisar. Not sure how you're supposed to say it. A couple of years ago, they tried to take over Hoover Dam, but the NCR beat them back. The NCR didn't or couldn't finish the job, though. The Legion's got its strength back and is getting ready for another round at the dam. My money's still on the NCR winning, but you never know. We've been hearing stories about legionaries on the Nevada side of the river, so keep a gun handy. You don't want to get caught by them.
You ever find anything good while prospecting?
Nope. Had a pretty good claim once, way out east by the river, but got run off by raiders. Eventually got too old to keep going out.
What's so important about Hoover Dam?
The dam powers a lot of New Vegas, and then there's all that clean water lying in Lake Mead, too. Anybody who owns the dam owns the territory.
You know anything about Victor?
The machine? Harmless, no matter what Trudy says. She thinks it's hiding something, but I think it's just a broken-down relic with no place to be.
Reminds me of someone. I'll see you then.
Keep your gun handy if you go poking around some of the abandoned places around here, like the schoolhouse. Critters move in there sometimes.
You're really not up to date with current events, are you, Easy Pete? Never mind. I don't suppose I've got a magazine that would help me here, really, do I? Nope. Never mind. I'm sure we can do without. In fact, having a few less NPCs chucking dynamite around would probably be a good thing. Let's go and see Doc Mitchell. Basically just go and get some free stim packs. Mercy, there you are.
How are you holding up?
Let's see. The town's going to be attacked by bandits. Anything you can do to help?
Seems like wherever I go, it's always the same. Folks just never leave each other alone. Oh, I'm not much good in a fight with my bum leg. And my supplies are scarce, but I'll give you what I can spare.
Cheers. Right then.
You take care now.
Nice old man. Very nice old man. I always hate to take the stim packs from him, really. Yeah, let's definitely leave it alone. Repaired that at least. Yeah, no, like I said, let's not go looting all this stuff. He's already given us, you know, that stuff at the start, and he's given us this extra stuff now. If he can't spare the rest, he can't spare the rest. That's fair enough. Now then. That's pretty much it, isn't it, really? Okay. Ringo. It's now or never, buddy. Don't mind the super mutant. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I interrupt you in the middle of your nap? I should try and use dynamite on the thing. That would wake him up, wouldn't it? useless bugger. Right, well. Up you get. Come on. Up, up, up.
So what's going on? Did Sonny agree to help us?
Sonny's with us.
Well, I guess that means we're ready to go. Unless you think there's something else you can do.
Yeah, let's do this.
All right, I'm ready. I hope.
Time to look alive. The Powder Gangers are here to play.
Where's Trudy and the rest?
They're getting set up in cover, but it might not go well unless we get out there soon.
How many are there?
At least six. They look pretty mean.
Let's go then.
I'll be set up near the store. Let's hope that the gang doesn't manage to make it that far.
Okay. Oh god. Off we go. Come on. Alright. I know you've been wanting to do this for a while. So here we go.
Motherfucker.
Right, I'm gonna drop a save, and here we go. Getting cover too, I didn't think of it.
motherfucker.
Get ready, man. Here they come. Go get him. Go on. Dude, seriously. Get shooting. Dude, get...
Motherfucker.
Oh, good heavens. This is not going well. There we go.
I owe you a huge favor for this. Here, these are technically Crimson Caravan funds, but I know they'll understand once I explain things.
Didn't I hear you say something earlier about not being able to pay me now?
I did have what was left of the Crimson Caravan money, but I wasn't sure if it was my right to just give it away. I owe you more than that, though, so look me up at the Crimson Caravan camp up in New Vegas if you ever visit.
Oh boy, I think we've got a bit of a sound glitch. This is why I don't let you use that thing. Well, it worked out well for us in the end, it seems.
Motherfucker.
Okay. To the victor, the spoils. Plated powder ganger armor. Single shotgun. All stuff to sell, really. You'd think this leather arm would be a bit useless, though, considering his arm and his leg were blown off, but whatever. Oh, it's Wanderer's leather armor. DT-12, good god. It's pretty good, actually. And guns plus 10, I suppose I'll wear that. Yeah, it's a little grubbier, but... doesn't look any worse, really, in my opinion. DT-12, come on. Seriously. That's too good. What else we got? More ammo. I'm selling all of this stuff. Did we take any casualties? I probably should have checked this first, I suppose, but... we look okay. I don't see any dead people. That aren't baddies, anyway. I don't see Easy Pete anywhere. Boxing gloves. I can't. They look too silly. They look just too silly. Knuckle dusters, yeah, fine. You know, power fist, absolutely. But boxing gloves, I fail to see how they even do more damage rather than using your bare fists, but whatever. Plasma pistol Mark II. Yeah, alright then. Throwing hatchet. Trooper helmet. Somehow I don't really think so. No, I... yep, no. Nope, it's not working for me. Well then, well, let's see, 1, 2, 3, there was the guy down there. Ah! You. Cowboy repeater. Ooh. Oh boy. Okay, right. Ugh.
Motherfucker.
Time me to carry a few things. Oh, better yet, I'll just put on my backpack. Forgot I had that thing. Right, yeah. Hmm. Recharge a pistol, eh? Okay. Where? I can't repair one with the other. That kind of sucks. Sell it for a heck of a lot of money, though. It's actually more valuable than the rifle, weirdly enough. It does slightly more damage, that's why. Oh, I don't know which one to keep now. I'd be better off with the pistol. Has it been modded at all? No. No, I think I'll keep the pistol. I'll sell the rifle. Seems more practical to me. What else have we got? We got this. Can't turn that big into plasma weaponry, though, honestly. It's kind of irritating with how slow the projectiles move, you know? It's a fair amount of damage, though. Can't argue with that too much. Prefer a laser stuff myself, though. And I've got a laser pistol at home, I think. That's very valuable, so yeah, I think we'll sell it. We'll sell that, we'll sell the recharger rifle, we'll sell all these single shotguns. Throwing hatchet. Submachine gun, yeah. Okie dokie. Was that everybody? One. Behind the rock. Two there. Three. Four over there. Five. Well, there's easy Pete. What the hell are you doing all the way out over there? Dude. What is going on? One, two. Three, four, five. No. Wait. Yeah, three, four, five. Where's number six? Oh, wait a minute. Six would have been including Cobb, except Cobb's dead. I'm guessing they just didn't alter dialogue. There we go. Right. Makes sense. Okay. We'll just leave it at that, I suppose. Do I do any ammo stuff? Oh, right, yeah. 308 rounds, what do I need? Lead. Lead. Crap. Lead. What can I... Can I make lead out of anything? Oh my god. Scrolling. It's on the list, I can't find it anywhere. Might need a perk to do it, but I'm pretty sure you can turn scrap metal into lead. Still. Something that I can break down. Both of these, really. I don't use shotguns, do I? I've got a sawn off back at home, but it's a bit rubbish. So... And we'll see, yeah, break down the 20 gauge. And we'll make Six 308 rounds. Not bad. 308 rounds are just sort of the be-all, end-all of ammunition as far as I'm concerned. My favorite guns, we always seem to use 308. Specifically this. Should start to run kind of low on ammo for, so, you know. Should have bought a case of lead while I was at that shop, shouldn't I?
That was a hell of a fight. Let's hope it doesn't bite us in the ass later on.
We can but wait and see. In the meantime, buy my stuff. All of it. I need to read that damn book. And you know what? You can have this revolver, because I've got a cowboy repeater now. That's better. I mean, just because it's a rifle, and I like rifles. There it is. Yeah. Not much in the way of ammo, though. Anyway. Okay, that's all my junk for 637 caps and a doctor's bag. So, done deal.
Give me a shout if you need any.
And, just thrown into the bargain, I got a few free 357 cases. So, oops. Make some of those. Which then gives me, yeah, 19 of them. That's pretty good, really. Which means that my cowboy repeater now has a, well, pretty threadbare amount of ammo, but better than nothing. Oh, yeah, I forgot. It has the weird peep sight on it, doesn't it? Ooh, might get the mod that removes that. I'm not sure. Think about it. But anyway, yeah, that's another neat little rifle, carbine, whatever you want to call it. To add to the collection. It is quite pretty, isn't it? I mean, that retexture obviously makes a big difference, but... Again, this retexture's working, even though the sniper rifles one isn't. Very strange. Might be an archive invalidation thing, if I had to guess. Anyway. Switch back to good old faithful. It really was a bit crap in that gunfight, though, wasn't it? It's good thing we had you and your minigun. Although I think I might have been having a few invisible wall issues there. I do get suggested to me the collision meshes mod. Any problem with the collision meshes mod is that when I tried to use it, it crashed my game. As soon as I tried to start a new game. So, yeah.
Motherfucker. Motherfucker.
I can give it another go at some point, but... At the time, I decided that I would just do without, because I was fed up of testing and trying to fix things at that point. I just wanted to get started with the LP, so... Okay, now what? Now, I'm trying to think. Ammo shop? No, I don't need to go to the ammo shop, because I've already got a shit ton of lead, I've noticed, from breaking down all that shotgun ammo, so...
That'll teach the powder gangs to avoid good springs in the future.
Yeah, What do you actually do around here?
I hunt geckos, mostly. The meat's pretty good, and I can always find a buyer for the hides. I also help keep the town clear of rat scorpions and coyotes. Not many people live in good springs, so wildlife is always creeping in.
Alright, let's talk about the areas around good springs.
Sure, what do you want to know?
What are the towns nearby?
Southeast of here is Prim. Can't miss it. Since it has the giant old roller coaster right in the middle of town. The NCR's got an outpost there. If you follow the road north, you'll eventually hit Sloan and Quarry Junction. They mine rocks or something, but I heard they got troubles lately. I wouldn't head that direction if I were you, though. Got critters up there that don't take kindly to getting shot.
NCR? Hmm? No, what kind of creatures are out there?
Around here, mostly coyotes and geckos. The coyotes are pretty dangerous in large packs, but otherwise they're nothing to really worry about. The geckos aren't too tough, but they've got a nasty bite. I've heard about bigger, nastier versions out in the wasteland, but I've never seen them. Stick to the roads when you can, and steer clear of the hills north of Good Springs. The critters up there are big and poisonous.
That's all I wanted to know.
If you want to know anything else, just ask.
Yeah, I need to get to Prim. Can you suggest a route?
Sure can. Take the road southeast out of town till it hits the freeway. Prim is the town with the roller coaster straight south. Can't miss it. NCR patrols do a good job of keeping the highway clear, but I'd keep your gun where you can reach it easily. You never know who you'll run into. Off the road, you'll probably start running into hostile wildlife. My advice would be to stick to the highway when you can.
Okay.
Until next time.
Sorry, brief pause there. Bit of background noise going on, so, Trudy!
I'm glad that business is over. I like it when Good Springs is nice and quiet.
Goodbye.
Be careful out there.
Ringo.
Thanks again for all your help.
What are the rules of Caravan, by the way?
It's a two-player game, and the winner takes the whole pot. You build a caravan using the cards in your deck. The goal is to create caravan bids that beat your opponent's bids, so there's more strategy than luck involved. It's why you won't see caravan in any casino. Too slow-paced. And more importantly, no house edge. Here, take this holotape. It goes into more specifics about the rules. You'll also need a deck, so take one of my spares. So, you feel like playing a game?
Not right now. Not right now.
All right.
Goodbye.
Yeah.
I might have a go at Caravan at some point, actually. I'll not interrupt Easy Pete with his dinner. I might have a go at Caravan at some point, because from what I remember, I can't remember how to play it, but from what I do remember, it was actually quite fun. I enjoyed it, so, anyway. I think we're pretty much done, Bertie. There's nothing left for us here in Good Springs other than our house, and, well, you know, we're not going to make any progress on that unless we, head on out into the wasteland itself. So I suppose, my dear fellow, it's about time we headed out into the wasteland and track down the charming young gentleman with the checkered suit who was so kind as to perform a little bit of impromptu wasteland brain surgery on yours truly.
Mr. New Vegas Show, the show with, in my opinion, which I respect, the best-looking audience around. Somebody prove me wrong? This just in. A package courier found shot in the head near Good Springs has reportedly regained consciousness and made a full recovery. Now that's a delivery service you can count on. Also, Good Springs has fended off a mob of escaped convicts after organizing an impromptu militia. This according to an old man, armed to the teeth